Hi, I'm Steve Casely from CBT Nuggets, and welcome to this nugget on peer-to-peer computing. In my humble opinion, a subject often overlooked in organizations' security policies, and often a subject that's overlooked by CISA auditors. We focus so much on everything that's going on inside that corporate network, that predefined, pre-approved, well-architected corporate network, and we forget about the fact that maybe, just maybe, there's some additional risks being introduced into the organization by peer-to-peer, computer-to-computer communications, potentially around the fringe of that beautifully architected network. And in the days of old, and I would say i.e. just a few years ago, peer-to-peer computing and the risks of that, I believe, were very real because our corporate networks, our infrastructures, was not as elaborate as discussed in previous nuggets. You may be going into an organization that is still working in days of old, so you absolutely have to have your radar up and looking for those instances where people are using PC to PC, computer to computer communications to ensure that all of the firewalls, all of the security processes are in place. Above and beyond that, there's lots of other concerns that happen within our network, but happens once we branch outside that network into this thing called the internet, the cloud. And we've talked already about the concerns of data leakage when people are using social media and technical message boards and blogs and so on. So I'm not going to get into the specifics of data leakage. The same thing can happen in terms of pure security risks. If people are using social media, whether it is Facebook, whether it is LinkedIn, above and beyond putting sensitive data information out there, what is the risk of getting the virus? What is the risk of getting the Trojans? The dot, 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 dots. Just because it is a trusted social media site doesn't mean someone is out there with the ability, and there's really smart, evil people out there in the world, folks, to be able to embed all of this stuff into a nice, innocent-looking Facebook post, or embedding some evil thing inside the proverbial movie of the cat jumping over a dog. In theory, all of our traditional network infrastructure and viruses should catch all of that. But we just need to make that special little bit of attention to make sure that's happening. Same thing on message boards. Our techies are always going to message boards, technical boards, looking for help, posting concerns, posting information up there. There's hundreds and thousands and millions of files out there on these technical message boards. How secure are they? Just because it is a trusted message board doesn't mean some evil person isn't lurking out there trying to destroy our organization through the technical message board. Beware of what you find on the internet, bottom line. Same thing goes for blogs. Instant messaging. A lot of organizations are going to set up a corporate instant messaging process. Chris has some wonderful nuggets out there on Link, now redefined as Skype for Business. If you're doing your instant messaging through a corporate messaging system, probably pretty secure. That's why our organization has gone out and purchased these corporate messaging boards as opposed to simply letting us use a public offered. Often our staff are not happy with just the corporate instant messaging. They still want to be able to talk to their spouses. They still want to talk to their friends. And they're going to be branching into other social networking processes, if allowed. So therefore, again, as an auditor, we need to be going in and validating that the appropriate checks and balances are in place to keep the instant messaging where it should be. And then lastly, to wrap up this nugget, I'm going to really harp on the importance of making employees aware. This is more an education than anything else, because we certainly can't ban our employees from having home networks. But just because our employee has a very toughened, hardened PC, when they take that home, they're connecting to a whole bunch of other PCs on that home network that probably aren't hardened and probably do not have all of the same security that we have built into our corporate networks. So what are the risks of literally letting staff connect to their home networks? They have children, or at least I have children, who go to potentially inappropriate sites and download what they think is an innocent game and end up infecting my home network with viruses. I try to maintain a very tough home network, but every now and then my kids beat me and find a way, not that they're deliberately going out there and trying to find ways to bring viruses into the house, but find ways to bring viruses into the house. So every time you let employees connect corporate PCs to home networks, or worse still, the current trend of bring your own device into the corporate network absolutely exposes our risks. I hope this nugget has been informative for you, and thank you very much for viewing.